Trash. By grinding several of these types of materials together, they have created a material called PRRF, post-industrial recycled fuel. When mixed with coal, PRRF extends the life of the coal, reducing the amount of fossil fuels needed and lowering our carbon footprint. Paper and cardboard materials are sorted, baled, and shipped to paper mills for reuse, while PRRF is used to fuel cement kilns. In 2022, alternative fuels such as PRRF represented 28% of Holcim's thermal energy demand. As part of their commitment to sustainability, Service Waste's goal is to increase that rate to 50% by 2030. Along with the 12,447 tons of items sold in our stores last year, Service Waste helped us to divert an additional 4,633 tons from the landfill through the recycling process. Goodwill also partners with Pan American Wire, who supply the wire used in our balers. This wire is used to tie bales and keep them compact and ready for shipment. Goodwill currently utilizes 8 balers across 4 locations. This process helps us save money and reduce waste at the same time.
From the first year that we were asked to participate in Project Goodwill, it had such a profound effect on me personally that I knew Service Waste and Pan American Wire would be sponsoring or somehow involved in this program. We were so touched by the stories of the participants at Goodwill and how they were able to be integrated into mainstream society and how they were being taught how to be independent and live independent lives, that they may not have had that opportunity were it not for Goodwill. And I want to thank Shay Gibson, Beth Renault, and David Cox for allowing us to be a participant in this program. Thank you so much.
If you're interested in how Service Waste can help your business become landfill free, visit their website at servicewaste.com.
Thank you once again, Service Waste and Pan American Wire. We truly appreciate your ongoing support. All right, it is not too late to bid on our amazing silent auction items that you saw in the lobby before the dinner started. Bidding will close at 8:30 p.m. this evening, so be sure to get your bids in for those items. There are QR codes on each table that you can scan to place your bids. After tonight's show, if you have won an item, we ask that you please go to the registration table in the lobby, and we have volunteers who are there ready to assist you with the payment and the pickup of your winning item. Now, as for tonight's mystery boxes, I understand that they are sold out. But if you were one of the lucky ones who got to purchase a mystery box, don't open it yet. We're going to hold on to those for now, and we will all open them together later in the program. I would also like to express our gratitude to all of the local businesses and individuals who donated to this year's silent auction and to our mystery boxes. You can find a listing of all of those businesses and individuals in your programs. At this time, I would like to ask you to sit back, relax, enjoy your dinner, and we will be back in just a little while to start our program. Thank you for being here this evening.
I'm gonna text me. Oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah. Your every picture, you might ignite to the shaper. Come be my teacher. I got a JoJo.
Destiny. You think you've got it, oh, you think you've got it, but got it, just don't get it to the...
Boy, don't get emotional, 'cause it's not personal. It's just the way. never broke up. Something to believe in. Got this self-fulfilling reputation. Talking like you're God's favorite creation. Nothing makes you smaller than being a big man. You be my revolver, got you in my hands. Almost looking taller when I'm leading in. Uh-oh. Have you never let a woman do that? You love my girl like me before. Just a taste, but you'd want more. Never met a girl like, never met a girl. Handsome, there ain't nothing sexy about a tantrum. Do you think you're ready or not? But probably not. Nothing makes you smaller than being a big man. You'll be my revolver, got you in my hands. Almost looking taller when I'm leading in the dark. Uh-oh. Have you never let a woman do that? You love my girl like me before. Girl, like I'd give you just a taste, but you'd want more.
Wasn't really in the plans. When you're around, I got arrhythmia. So in the end, I play pretend. You got the of a cool dip. But you should know I like it hot. But if there's really no denying what this is, then come on, let's give it a shot.
Good evening. Good evening, everyone. I'm Shay Gibson, the Vice President of Community Engagement for Goodwill North Central Texas. That works.
And I'm Liz Canfiliano, the Director of Community Engagement for Goodwill.
We've been working with 16 incredible designers for the last 5 weeks, and they have been working really hard to put on a great show for you all tonight. So we're going to let you know what they've been challenged with. All of these designers have been tasked with creating a blue carpet look using unconventional materials from Goodwill North Central Texas stores using a budget of only $100. They will be judged on communication, expression, design and construction, and the use of unconventional materials. The prizes for our contestants tonight are really great, and so that's why they've been working so hard. There is a social media influencer award, and that award is given to the contestant that's gotten the most likes and interactions on social media, and they will get a social media influencer kit. Our People's Choice winner tonight will get a trophy provided by Trophy Arts, a set of croquis for all bodies by Anthony L., and $250 cash.
Then our third place winner will receive a trophy provided by Trophy Arts, $500 cash, a $100 gift certificate to Goodwill North Central Texas, a sewing body form, a sewing machine cover, and a set of croquis for all bodies by Anthony L. Our second place winner will also get a trophy, $750, a $100 gift certificate to Goodwill, a sewing body form, a sewing machine cover, and a set of croquis.
Our first place winner tonight will receive a trophy provided by Trophy Arts, $1,000 in cash, a gift certificate for $100 to Goodwill North Central Texas, the Fashion Business Manual, which is an illustrated guide to building their own fashion brand, a rocket book, a set of croquis by Anthony L., a sewing body form, a sewing machine cover, and a Singer sewing machine. That deserves a hand. We have a great panel of judges this evening who will be judging our designs, and we want to introduce them all to you tonight. First up is Miss Lindsay Baylor. Wave, give us a wave. Lindsay Baylor is a native Texan with roots in Louisiana. She is currently the Senior Director of Customer Care and DEIB for Kendra Scott LLC based in Austin, Texas. Before joining Kendra Scott in 2020, Baylor was the Vice President of Operations for BioWorld Merchandising in Irving, Texas, where she built and framed her career, as well as her passion for merchandising, customer service, and operations for nearly 12 years. A proud mom of her son, Cairo, they enjoy watching and playing basketball and watching all things Marvel. Thank you, Lindsay, for joining us tonight. Next, we have Joe Allen Brown. Joe is a senior professor at Texas Wesleyan University. In his 46 years at Texas Wesleyan, he served as chair of theater for 22 years, dean of the School of Fine Arts for 7 years, and then dean of freshmen for 19 years, and is currently back serving as chair of Theater Wesleyan. Joe is a past recipient of the Live Theater League of Tarrant County's Lifetime Achievement Award and its Theater Advocacy Award. He has previously served as president of the Live Theater League. Joe has directed and designed for various theaters in the area, including Circle Theater, Jubilee Theater, Amphibian Theater Stage West, and Artisan Center Theater. He is currently the vice president for the board of Jubilee Theater and designing the scenery for Wesleyan's 69th spring musical, Natasha Pierre and the Great Comet of 1812. Thank you, Joe, for joining us.
Our next judge is Kanani Mahalona. After working as a designer and pattern maker in the once flourishing Dallas apparel industry in the 1980s, Kanani left the manufacturing field to enter the then new field of computer-aided design. After a 25-year textile technology career that took him all over the world from his home base in New York City, Kanani started his own consulting company. During that time, Kanani connected with Goodwill North Central Texas and began flying from New York to Fort Worth to participate as a judge for Project Goodwill. In 2019, Kanani and his husband Ralph left New York to help their struggling grandson in, of all places, Fort Worth. After homeschooling Jackson for 2 years, they discovered the Key School and enrolled Jackson for his sixth grade year. Kanani now serves on the board of directors for Key School. Thank you, Kanani, for coming back. Next, we have Deireen Morrow. She's the founder and CEO of the Diva of Curves TX, a plus-size secondhand shop that provides affordable and sustainable plus-size fashion solutions. Born and raised in Charlotte, North Carolina, Morrow earned her Master of Business from Strayer University in 2017. She has since made it her personal goal to provide quality, plus-size fashion for all. She is privileged to work with local nonprofits like Goodwill that are directly connected to her mission. In the future, Morrow plans to partner with local organizations to teach minorities about sustainability, efforts as a pathway to increase knowledge of engineering, agriculture, technology, and mathematics in our communities. Thank you, Dee Dee.
Last but not least, we have Kate Oxley, who holds a Bachelor of Fine Arts in Theater Performance from Baylor University and serves as the Director of Fine Arts at Harvest Christian Academy in Keller, Texas, where she directs, as well as designs and creates sets and costumes for theatrical productions. She has also performed on stage as well as voice characters in cartoons, video games, movies, and commercials. Kate is a three-time recipient of the People's Choice Award and a two-time first place winner of Project Goodwill. Thank you for coming back, Kate. You can learn more about all of our judges in your programs. Now we want to introduce our special guest and celebrity host, Mr. Anthony L. Anthony L., hailing from Los Angeles, California, is a multi-talented force in the fashion and entertainment industry. Not only is he the esteemed winner of Project Runway All-Stars, but he's also the proud guardian to his beloved niece, infusing his life with both creative brilliance and familial love. Renowned for his exceptional talent in costume design, Anthony has left an indelible mark on television, particularly as the mastermind behind the captivating wardrobe of the Emmy-winning series, The Crossover, streamed on Disney+. His designs have graced the frames of numerous celebrities, including the likes of Nicole Ari Parker, Queen Latifah, Lala Anthony, and Billy Porter, solidifying his status as a sought-after fashion visionary. Beyond his professional achievements, Anthony is deeply committed to serving his community, showcasing his altruism as a dedicated advocate. His recent triumph on the Barbie Dreamhouse Challenge and victorious stint on season 4 of Rock the Block on HGTV further underscore his versatility and creative prowess. While Anthony thrives in the world of film and television, he also continues to design under esteemed Anthony L. Couture label. Moreover, he has embarked on a new chapter as an author, currently writing his inaugural novel. With boundless creativity and a heart for storytelling, Anthony L.'s journey is one of inspiration, innovation, and unwavering passion for his craft. Please welcome Anthony L.
Hi. Now listen, I wore the shiniest things I own this evening to make sure you could see me. I am probably about to pass out from the smell of this glue, honey, holding these crystals on, but hello and welcome. Give yourselves a hand. Well, that was the rehearsal. Give yourselves a hand for that. But listen, I already know y'all get cocktail before we get in here, so we're going to do this again. Give yourselves a hand. Okay. Well, I know we have children tonight, so I want to first of all say thank you for having me. And Lord, please don't let me say none of the cuss words that I'm not supposed to say. Because, oh, now everybody going to act like they don't cuss in front of their kids. But I'm not going to do it. Trying to stay booked. All right. Y'all look good. Can I say that, Shay? I know I'm supposed to keep going, but I got to talk to the audience because they weren't talking back earlier. They're barely clapping. Hey, you told me you was going to get that job, and you got it. You the chairperson on the board. Oh, I reads, and I read that. All right. Listen, we have 16 contestants for you. How many? 16. There will be a call and response. You will pay attention. And I want to thank y'all for this nice podium, giving me a waistline. Don't stop. No, I'm not. Okay, so we have 16 contestants. Listen, they are vying for your attention. And without further ado, we're going to see an incredible video which details a little more who they are and what you can expect from them. Can we get that video, please?
Hi, my name is Katiba Johnson.
My name is Taylor Moore.
My name is Fernando, and I am a student at Trumbull Tech.
I am a teacher with Fort Worth ISD at Southwest High School.
I am an owner of my own business.
I am a Navy veteran and a homeschool mom.
And this is my first time in Project Goodwill.
This is my second time participating in Project Goodwill.
This is my fourth year competing in Project Goodwill.
I love fashion because I usually like doing fashion on myself, and I like doing it on the others. It's like my favorite thing.
Honestly, I wanted to have a creative outlet, and I had such a good experience the first time. I couldn't miss out on the chance to be able to create again.
I've always coming up with things in my head, but I never fully like executed it. So I feel like it's a good way for me to put something out there that I'm proud of.
I always been drawn into like unconventional challenges.
I like thrifting, and I've made things from thrifted goods before, so I was like, you know what, why not? I come from a very creative family, so we always like creating. I've always been like drawing and stuff. So yeah, I've just always loved making things.
Last year, I really focused on using more non-conventional materials. I just went through the process of looking for my one unique non-conventional material, and then I built off of it from that.
I kind of want to build on what I did last year, which is like have fun and kind of have fun with the process. So I'm trying to, you know, build on doing something different and keeping your foundation the same, but like, you know, adding some new things into the mix.
One of my big takeaways from last year was really just you have to go big, and that's what I plan on doing this year. I plan on going big.
To me, the fun parts are the actual like designing and then doing all the hunting. And also like, I like the part of creating content for social media and kind of showing like little snippets.
I'm looking to kind of have my story for this year's garment kind of be a reflection of the past year I've had. And I'm really excited. I'm hoping that my energy and my positivity goes into the outfit that I create this year.
I love competition. Is the first thing is the mission of Goodwill. It brings help a lot of people, and from there I can like learn a lot and from about fashion and going forward with it.
I like a challenge and I like to learn from my challenges and stuff. And I think this is a really good way for me to learn and not just that, but also help people.
Being able to take part in this project, Goodwill, is super meaningful to me. It very much mirrors the work I do and why I love working in higher education. It's the same philosophy for me. It's transforming lives. And so to be able to be a part of that and to bring awareness to the mission of Goodwill, it's a very fulfilling experience that I'm very grateful to get to do for the third year.
You know, I've always been a big supporter of Goodwill. I mean, I'm already coming back to get some stuff for some of my students for some of the artwork that they're doing. And then I know of other students with disabilities who have come here and gone through the process, and it has helped them tremendously.
It feels good. I think my first year, I didn't really realize what I was doing, but my second year, it kind of set in. I think I've grown a lot in these past 3 years, and it means a lot knowing that all this effort isn't just going into this competition, but it's helping Goodwill as a whole and their mission.
I think this competition helps you grow in a way. You learn a little bit about yourself.
I just think it will be neat to encourage other veterans, other moms, to, you know, push yourself and try new things. I have this dream of like creating like a little sewing group for people who have PTSD. I hope to inspire somebody and have fun and create something.
I'm most excited to see all the looks and what everyone else has created and to like be amazed by what they made.
I know what the competition's like. I know they're very talented, and so I've really got to stretch myself a little further.
I definitely feel pressure from my parents and my family. They're my biggest supporters, and so I definitely will hear them out on them wanting me to win first place, but I think they just want me to have a good time and just, you know, start something, finish it, and it look great.
Bagging it, baby. You know it. I came to slay, not to play.
So what did y'all see? Because I couldn't see a thing. Was it a good video? We can do this all night. See, the good thing about Goodwill NCT, they clear your check before you go on stage. So y'all can keep clapping because I'm going to keep asking, did you enjoy the video? Thank you. Sir at the table with the hands, thank you. Thank you. I respect your effort. It is not in vain. Thank you. Now listen, get your phones out, because I need you to go to slido.com and enter event code, hashtag Project Goodwill. No, I don't see you moving. Obedience is still better than sacrifice. I need you to get out your phone, because you have to cast your vote for whatever contestant you enjoy. If you have people at your table without their phones, call them out. Raise their hand for them. Let me know. Oh, sure. It's slido.com. You have cards at your table, or you may see it in your program. We're doing really great at this first table. Thank you. Is everybody at your table registering back there? The people all the way to the far left, y'all think y'all can get away with murder. I will walk over there. Okay, I see phones out. Are we all registered? Just lie and say you are. Just, you know. Shay, are you registered at your table? Okay, we're good at Shay's table. Y'all give Shay a hand. She does an incredible job of booking me. She and Liz do a wonderful job. They are an incredible class act. Anthony, send me your picture. I forgot. But they don't cuss or say anything. Okay. So now that we're registered on slido.com, guess what happens next? The show begins. Round of applause. No, don't play the music yet. That's a round of applause. These children have worked hard, and they need your support. And that's another thing. Listen, I'm serious. Just because they're not your cousin don't mean you don't clap for them. These people have worked hard. And I know what it's like to be rejected in reality. I don't need to go into my backstory. All right, without further ado, let's get this show started, ladies and gentlemen. This clapping going to wear me out. Thank you. All these damn crystals, y'all better clap. All right, we have our first contestant, Leslie Acevedo. Materials used, 2 bed sheets, 3 packs of surgical masks, 2 books, 4 paint canvases, 3 packs of plastic drop cloth. She embedded this garment with hues of Goodwill. Can you see it?
I do.
Look at those handmade flowers at the top. Those are made from book pages. Go back halfway, sis. Let them see what you got again. Look at the pages on the skirt. You better twirl. I ain't said twirl, but you better do it. Come on back. Ladies and gentlemen, if you like what she's wearing, give her a hand. This is Leslie Acevedo. All right. All right, ladies and gentlemen, next we have Anahí Álvarez. I said, ladies and gentlemen, we have Anahí Álvarez. Thank you. All right. She used, now walk slow, sis. She got a dissertation on here. 4 packs of 20-count photo paper. That's what the rosettes are made of. 2 packs of cardstock paper, 1 roll of craft paper, 1 tablecloth, 1 bed sheet, 1 bed skirt, 19 stems of Christmas decorations, 1 metal basket, 2 packs of tulle, DIY fly screen. Let them see the back, sis. That's why you came out here. All right, her inspiration was the bridal world. She wants to create a garment that would be appropriate for the runway. All right, she used scrapbook paper and craft paper to construct the flowers. That's incredible. And look at the pleated detail on the bust. If you like what she's wearing, give her a hand. Y'all are doing beautifully. Thank you. That's Anahí Álvarez. Girl, I thought you had failed. I ain't got nervous. Y'all know we would. Anyway, moving on. Christy. Y'all know when I start laughing, I can't stop. Don't do that. Okay. Now we have Christy Burrish. You better come through, Christy. She used the curtain, fishing net, shells, vase filler, rope, garage door belt. That's what she put the bones on with, the garage door belt, y'all. Placemats. Shell wall pocket, fishing net, 2 belts, Christmas earrings, bra, and a dust ruffle. Christy found her design inspiration while shopping for her supplies. Y'all remember the seashells your mama used to have on the wall in the bathroom? That's what that handbag is. Under the sea. Yeah. That's nice. Look at all that sparkle. That's netting. Oh, wonder what the poor people doing today. All that nice luxury. Thank you. Love to see Cheryl bag. All right. Oh, hold on. She had 2 pages. Amen. Next, we have Madison Davis. She used 2 purses, 2 lampshades, 3 kitchen mats, a piano toy, that's what she made the top out of, flotation toy, a lace top, a velvet dress, 2 packs of bungee cords, 4 tire covers, silver bedding, sheer curtains, and gold shoes. Madison's inspiration for her garment is elegant and edgy. She combined the two to create a gown that highlight, I'm gonna say cocktail dresses, that highlights the feminine side and the strong side of a woman. Now you did that, huh? Let them know old broom can still sweep, honey. That's what you're supposed to do. Next, we have Jacqueline Hernandez. Ooh, all right. Oh, now y'all want to clap. Okay, so materials. She used face masks. This whole entire garment at the bottom, those are face masks. You know the ones we wore during the coronavirus situation intensely? Tore y'all up. Hey, all right. She was inspired by her first purchase of the competition, 2 granny couch pillows. Oh, really? Which had a very pretty design that reminded her of the Renaissance and the dreamy art of the time period. She purchased other items that matched the theme and turned them into beautiful corsets. Hold on, I got more notes. Did you know she painted the bottom? Gone back halfway again, sis. No, there you go. And she used book pages on the skirt. If you like what she's wearing, give her a hand, ladies and gentlemen. That's nice. I respect the girl who knows how to throw her train. I like that. All right, Jacqueline, you did a great job. Oh, I ain't supposed to say nothing. All right. Lord, thank you. This might be my last year. All right, next we got Julie Hood. Come through, Julie. All right, the materials that she used, placemat, a pillow, faux flowers, a pillowcase, curtains, and she's the designer as well as the model. A fabric box container, a dress, a blouse, a plaque, a stacked shoe storage, a file box, and wallpaper. Julie was inspired by the retro color scheme of the placemats she found. Her theme is retro with a touch of modern. And she used wallpaper for her handbag, and the vest is made of placemats. Did you show them that bag, Julie? And she used hat stiffener. That was regular fabric, y'all, and she stiffened it and then modified the shape. I think that deserves a round of applause. Thank you, Julie Hood. Well, I got these gloves on, so I can't turn these pages like I used to. All right, next we got Katiba Johnson. Ooh. All right. At the Goodwill. Okay. This is the avant-garde look. All right. She used a rope, birdcage flowers, plants and butterflies, shoestrings, as well as table placemats. Okay, now she said that the flowers were used in France for protection. They would hang those kind of flowers on the door. She learned it in one of her religious classes. I think I got the notes right. And the bag is a birdcage. We look like y'all like that. It's okay. There you go, sis. Keep going. Thank you, Katiba's model. You know what? I learned that about y'all. Y'all like a little skin. That's why I gave y'all this little sliver. Just a little sliver, honey. That's all I got. Everything to the left and the right. Anyway, listen. Next. Thanks, boo. All right, next we have Marisol Lopez. Yeah, Shay, I think this is my last year. Materials. Now listen, you're going to have to slow it down, sis. She used a fitted bed sheet, a flat bed sheet, 10 fabric placemats, macrame wall hanging, shoelaces, 2 lampshades, khaki pants, paperback book, beaded shirt, crown home decor. Now here go the notes. She was inspired by romance. And she wanted to create a storybook princess. Anthony, how you can't read your own writing? She was inspired by Rococo and Barbie. Did you know I had my own custom Barbie made last year? No one cares, Anthony. And she hand-stitched the eyelets in the back. Turn to the back. You know, when you see a corset and it has the little holes in the back, she hand-stitched those. Sure did. And she used a lampshade for the foundation, for the structure. This is a very unique silhouette. And she did what? And she used a pillow. Go with that. If you like what she's wearing, give her a hand. Ooh, I need my powder puff car. All right, we coming. Jose Martinez, thank you, Carl. Jose Martinez, here we go. All right, Jose used 2 leather jackets, a metal sun decoration, and 2 window curtains. Now, he's into astrophotography. Did you know that was a thing? He is into that. He's also into constellations, as well as he was inspired by the solar eclipse. Total eclipse of the heart. Bodice leather jackets, and he used a shower. The skirt is a shower curtain, and that is actual metal at the top of that. If you like what she's wearing, give her a hand. You heard that, Jose. They like it. And just Anthony's note, it's the fit for me. I don't believe he got that level of fit out of that material. It's incredible. You look good and know it, don't it? I was going to wear my ponytail, but I'm glad I did. All right, we have a return contestant. Emily, you ready? Emily Mitchell. All right now. All right. Y'all ready for this? She's wearing 12 dusters, 3 bunches of decorative grapes, that's what she made the necklace out of, 5 tarps, that's what she made the dress out of, 1 umbrella cover, I don't know where that went, and 1 pair of shoes. Now her inspiration was old Hollywood glam from a book that she found. From a book she found, I said. She used radiator dust. Now listen, she used radiator dusters for the shrug. So for all of you who threw your radiator dusters out, this is the potential you missed out on. She used a tarp for the dress. She believes in modernity. Yeah, you did a great job. That's what we call a high fashion duster situation. Give it up for Emily, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, I was talking too much. Give it for Emily again. No clapping left behind. Next, we have Sam Munson. All right, now. Sam used a yoga mat, sunshade, bag of paracord, mesh backpack, Christmas lights, cables, knit dress, curtains, blanket, shoes, HDMI cables, you better model, audio cord, and a microphone. Those are Christmas lights that are used for the adornment in the back. Did y'all see that? Bet you didn't know that was Christmas lights, and you threw yours away. All right, get into the details. The yoga mat was used for the structure of the coat, and the pants are curtains. Show him your curtains. Don't worry, he got on some modesty shorts, because that's some sheer fabric. She just did a slither. Okay. Inspiration is Rick Owens. Cabling done by hand. And the coat was quilted from a duvet cover. You better sell the garment. Where y'all playing? You did a great job. Does anybody know what time the restaurant closes? I think I'm gonna need a snack. All right, next we have Deanna Montalvo. All right now. All right. Let her hear you if you like what she's wearing. She is wearing 3 burgundy window curtains, 1 black lace dress, 1 silky black women's top, 1 black stretch belt, 2 packs of red hair dye. Hair dye? Oh. 1 home decor flowers. Okay, that's the little flowers on the dress, and she dyed those, y'all. She is a Navy veteran. The designer is a Navy veteran as well as a mom. Thank you for your service. I said thank you for your service. All right, and she wants to pursue merchandising. This is a 6-panel, yeah, you gotta wait, sis. This is a 6-panel skirt made of curtains, Christmas tinsel on the umbrella. Show them your umbrella, sis. Boom, you got that. And the hand-dyed flowers. If you like what she's wearing, give her a hand, ladies and gentlemen. Could you be recording and taking pictures, please? I'm almost done. I need pictures. The people won't believe I was here. All right, next we have Taylor Moore. Me and take pictures of me, Carl. All right, she used 10 packages of insect window screens, 1 bed sheet, 1 pair of faux leather pants, 1 pair of boots, 4 loofah bath sponges, that's on the train of the skirt she took off, 1 carpet runner, and 1 purse. You look great. She is the designer and the model. That's right. When you're competing, bring a friend too. She is inspired by the transformative nature of this competition. She used bed sheets on the skirt, loofah as the trim, bed, and she used leather pants for the belt. All right, you giving gothic Tinkerbell vibes. I'm here for it. If you like what she's wearing, give her a hand, ladies and gentlemen. I feel like calling. Does anybody have a good picture? Oh, anyway. Tran Fan is our next contestant. You better come on through. All right. She used a lampshade, a ruffle skirt, city wall painting, vinyl disc album, tablecloths. You better whoa. Gold and silver confetti push toppers, wreath frame, and a photo album. Her skirt is from an actual painting. Yes, she used a painting and bed sheets. And she also used vinyl records. And she used in her handbag. Do you see the handbag? It's a city made out of vinyl records. You ain't never made no city out of no vinyl records. Give her a hand, ladies and gentlemen. You look good. Oh, and that hat is a vinyl record, too. All right. All right. Next, we have Fernando Ruiz. Fernando, I got your first name right now. Ooh. Next. Okay. The model is wearing bed sheets, a jacket, sequin dress, Christmas ornaments, as well as lampshade. I wrote the word down chic in my notes, so go with that. It is chic. The designer Fernando was inspired by YSL 1992, drape as well as sparkle. The peplum is a lampshade. The corset is made from a shoe rag. Did y'all hear that? I said the corset is made from a shoe rag. Listen, Joan of Arc, wish she could. You look incredible. And we like the Christmas ornaments at the bottom. If you like what she's wearing, give her a hand. Uh-huh. All right. Next we have the model and the designer in one. We have Ty Washington. Giving you shades of blue. All right. She used two flat jersey sheets, three pillowcases, one window curtain, two 12-inch albums, one purse, one pair of boots. All right, and this beautiful shades of blue look. Do you like what? Oh, wait a minute. She transforming. She says it's brunch by day and happy hour by night. Her words, not mine. And she also covered the boots. Oh, you still transforming. I'm gonna wait for you. Okay, this is a one piece. It is connected to the boots. Huh. Spin one more time, because see the sleeve? Told y'all up, you weren't ready for that. Y'all weren't ready. Ty, you look good. I just can't see where you used the record. I can't see it, I'm just playing, it looks great. I love the way you used it. Wait a minute, that was my last contestant. All right, round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. How we doing now? All right. Now, this is where you keep clapping for all that rehearsal you've been doing. We will have our parade of designs. Let's go. Uh-oh. Now I got to say your names again. Hold on. All right. We got Leslie Acevedo. Uh-oh. Anae Alvarez. Christy Burrish. Anthony, you shouldn't have wore these gloves. I don't hear you clapping. We have Madison Davis, Jacqueline Hernandez, Julie Hood, Katiba Johnson. Keep clapping. Marisol Lopez, Jose Martinez, Emily Mitchell. They're going to be off the stage. I'm going to still be saying names. Sam Munson, keep clapping. Deanna Montalvo. Taylor Moore. Tran Fan. Fernando, oh, I'm still saying that. Fernando Ruiz and Ty Washington. Give them all the round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Okay. All right. Listen. Now, you have the power to do something that we've done for a long time in this country. Vote. Do the best you can. I understand. But just try to place your vote. No, we need you to vote for what contestant you enjoyed this evening. So go to Slido.com, or is it a barcode they scan, Shay? Scan the barcode at your table. We have made it really easy for you. These people need your vote. Sir in the navy blue with the tie, have you voted? You did? Who else got a table that know they voted? Let me hear you. All y'all got on blue. And nobody voted. Did y'all vote? Well, let me hear your table. Represent. Well, no. Remind me not to do nothing. Okay. All right. After the online. Oh, this is a note for me. Don't read that note out loud. All right. Shay. It's you, Shay. Well, listen, I just want to talk to y'all while Shay approaches the audience walking very slow. What? Okay, his is not Shay. This is David, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you, Anthony. Let's give one more round of applause for that show. Wasn't that amazing? Judges have a very rough time ahead of them as they finalize their votes. And while they do that, I would like to direct your attention to the screens. We have two short videos that shows you the good work of Goodwill in our community. So please join me in watching these videos.
Lupe has Down syndrome. After she graduated, we just kind of waited at home until something opened up for her, for us to put her in. So when Goodwill opened up their program to her and she was able to be accepted, she came here.
The STARS program is a dayhab for adults with disabilities, and we teach them social skills, independent living skills, and daily living skills.
My parents were very thankful when they found out about Goodwill. They were really worried when Lupe first aged out of high school, because she was like, what are we gonna do? We want her to keep learning, keep interacting with people. We don't just want her here closed off to the world.
First met Lupe when she arrived here about, I think it's a year ago, and her personality was at the time probably a little bit shy, but very quickly she moved out of that shell, and she loves music and she loves the smile. And she loves movement around lunchtime, a lot of dancing.
I think her favorite part of the STARS program is the music, because she loves to dance. And usually, if you're looking for her after break or at lunch, she's somewhere dancing.
She's more outgoing. She's learned to better express herself.
I love STARS. I love Goodwill. It's my favorite, because it's my favorite time here. My favorite class is Miss Lenta's room. I love how she teaches me. She teaches me about everything.
So I'm very proud that she can think for herself. It's the fact that she doesn't come to us and ask for every little thing. She's learned to, I can do this, I can do that. So if she needs clothes, she knows she can go and reach them for herself now. If she needs to take a shower, she knows that, okay, it's time for my shower. And there's little things like that that she's gotten better. So Lupe is a very lovable person. Anyone she meets, she automatically loves them. It's hard to live up to, because I feel like she sets the bar high and then the rest of us are really low with interacting with others.
The reason I enjoy this job is because if you come here in a bad mood, our participants will lift you up. They understand the true meaning of life and they live in the moment.
She brightens my day because she's so bubbly and happy all the time. Makes me feel good as a manager that we are actually doing something that makes her happy. After high school, that's when Darius came to us, when he graduated high school. And you know, his mom told us otherwise he wouldn't have anywhere to go during the day. So going to Goodwill Stars gives him a purpose, having somewhere to go, have a job. Just knowing that we've been able to help Darius out, that makes me happy.
He's a team player. Darius works well with others. He comes in with a bright personality, with this sunshine.
I think being in the program, for one, and being around other individuals has helped him a lot.
He was getting ready to go into pre-K. He was 3 years old at the time, and mishap, unfortunate, we were in a car accident. And we were hit by a drunk driver, and it left Darius with a brain injury. He was, you know, potty trained, he was walking, he was doing everything, getting ready for school, and then this happened. And it was really hard at first, because I had him to take care of, and I had a mother that was sick to take care of. So I had both of them. So everything was, you know, for him was done at home. It was a time they said they didn't know how much time I would have with Darius. But look at him. He's graduated from high school. Now he has this job that he loves. Before the STARS program, he was still in Special Olympics. We got him into STARS, and he's just been blossoming ever since.
STARS program gives the individuals a purpose, you know, to come and to learn, socialize with peers, just be out in the community with individuals. It's a day program for adults with disabilities, teaching socialization skills, daily living skills. We have several different classrooms. We have an art room, fitness room, apartment, teaching them daily living skills, community and vocational. They go out into the community and get some community training as well.
When he got the job with Edgar, I was just excited because he tells me about it every day.
Edgar's Bath Goods is a bath and body line that's created to help us to employ our adults with disabilities here in the STARS program. We make bath bombs, we make bath powder, we make shower gel and lotion, and everything is all natural.
You put the ingredients in, and you put the color in, and let it mix for 3 minutes. And after that, you mix it, you scrape the bottom of the bowl to see the white. And after that, you put the oil in. The essential oil. We make Edgar's Fit Signature and Fit Make and Blue Bonnet and Pearl Sunset, and I like all of them.
He works with his hands, and it's just, he loves it. And I just love to see him come home every day with that smile. I'm very proud of Darius, very proud of Darius.
I enjoy being a manager because I can see individuals grow. Open up, you know, increase skills, job-wise or social skills, daily living skills.
I've learned a lot by working with them. Their personalities are wonderful, and so that does create a sense of community. They're working together. They collaborate with one another, and they create a great environment for themselves.
I am grateful for the Goodwill program, because, you know, I work, and then it was a place for him to go and for him to meet friends, because he's an only child. So it opened him up a lot. I'm just overwhelmed at the remarkable young man that Darius has become, and he is still striving.
Lupe, Darius, I don't see where you are, but would you please stand and be recognized? Let's give them a round of applause. They're both here this evening. Lupe and Darius, you truly embody the vision of Goodwill North Central Texas. As a matter of fact, our vision statement is that every person in our community would have the opportunity for maximum independence and abundant living. When I watch these videos, I see Lupe realizing her independence. I see Darius living abundantly. And this, friends, is what Goodwill is all about. Goodwill is much, much more than just a thrift store, which I think you have all seen this evening. Goodwill exists to provide employment and training to people with disabilities or other barriers to employment, such as homelessness, incarceration, poverty, or lack of education. Our program that was featured in tonight's video segments was our Innovative Stars program, which serves people with multiple or significant disabilities. Both Lupe and Darius are shining stars of this program indeed. And theirs are just two of the stories of Goodwill. Last year, Goodwill North Central Texas served over 11,000 people right here in Greater Fort Worth. I think that deserves a round of applause. The other good news is that your participation here tonight helps us to help the community. If you like what you've seen this evening and you like what you've heard and would like to continue your support of Goodwill, I would like to invite you to make a monetary donation to Goodwill. We have volunteers all around the room. They're wearing black with blue corsages. I believe there's envelopes on your table. If you would like to make a donation, we would like to make that as easy as possible, accepting either cash, credit cards, or checks. You can also go to the silent auction page and you can give electronically through that. Last but not least, the beautiful floral arrangements on each table are available for purchase at the conclusion of this evening for a minimum donation of $25, and there are also envelopes on your table for you to be able to do that. Regardless of how you give, please know that your donations are very much appreciated and will pay huge dividends in the life of the people that we serve right here in our local community. With that, it's my pleasure to ask Anthony to come back to the stage for the exciting culmination of our evening. Anthony?
Thank you, David. I want y'all to know, thank you, David. You are incredible, an incredible CEO. Listen, my right foot gave out on me when I was walking away. Practice in your heels, people, before you wear them. Okay, like, we got to get straight to business. What's going to happen is we're going to have each look come out very quickly because we need you to vote. V-O-T-E, vote, okay? And judges, we're gonna throw it to you in case you have anything insightful you wanna share, but this is gonna go very fast. Music. All right, first we have Leslie Acevedo. This is where you go to slido.com if you want to say that you like this look. Oh, you ain't gotta go all the way down, sis. Okay, well, you there now. To all the models in the back, we're gonna stop right here in the middle. But you can twirl, spin, whatever you want to do. Judges, do you have anything you want to share about this look? All right, we're going to move forward. Have you casted your vote? Thank you. Next, we have Anaye Alvarez. All right. What is that, an almost clap? All right, judges, do you have anything you want to share on this look?
The back is incredible. Take a look at that. It's amazing.
I'm sorry, what was that?
The back is incredible.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
The back is incredible. Cast your votes if you agree. All right, thank you. Next we have designer Christy Burrish. All right now.
Under the sea.
All right. I love this look. I hope you do too. If you do, go to slido.com. Any words from our judges?
Yes, we love the detail. I don't know if you can see it from where you're sitting, but the attention to detail in every inch of this look was really impressive.
Thank you. Give our judges as well as our model a hand. All right, next we have Madison Davis. That's right. Tell a friend and bring one. I like that. All right, judges, do we have any notes? Anything we want to share? I see a reach.
I'm a college teacher. I want to add that several of our contestants come from Trimble Tech High School and are designing these outfits. Yay for what our high schools are doing to encourage fashion design.
All right, cheers to that high school. I don't know what the name of it he said, but Triple Tech, Trimble. Write it down and send it to me here. But cheers to high school and the memories it gave us and the scars. All right, next we have Jacqueline Hernandez. Oh, woo, 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 woo. All right. All right, judges, do we have any words on this look?
We love the texture of that capelet. The pleats from the face masks are amazing.
All right, they love the texture. If you like what she's wearing, go to slido.com, scan the QR code. I said, scan. What y'all doing over here? You know what? Thank you. I said, over here. You can't be absent. Because you can't be absent and present at the same time. Who was that, y'all? Jacqueline Hernandez. Next, we have Julie Hood. Y'all ain't helping me. Hey, any notes from our judges?
Of course. I am such a vintage girl, and so I was so here for this look. I love the detailing, the colors, just the texture of the overall garment were just here for me.
Thank you, Judge. If you like what she's wearing, give her a hand and go to Slido. Thank you, Julie. All right, Katiba Johnson is our next designer. Uh-huh. All right, go to Slido. You better smile. Go to Slido.com. All right, judges, notes.
So I definitely love the storytelling behind this look.
Oh.
I think she was extremely intentional about her design and making sure those elements represented her and what she wanted us to understand. So I just love the storytelling behind it.
Nice. Thank you. You better tell the story, write the vision. All right, next we have Marisol Lopez. Ooh. Are those crystals on your teeth? I love it. Okay. Go ahead. Hey, what I see up here. All right. Listen, if you like what she's wearing, I need you to go to slido.com. You feel beautiful, don't you? Well, you look beautiful. And I like the little kiss of curl in the front. Mm-hmm. She got her edges. All right. Thank you. You're incredible. All right. Next, we have Jose Martinez, designer Jose Martinez. Okay. Listen, go to slido.com. Let Jose know you like what his model is wearing. Do we have any notes from he already got the microphone in his hand. Say something.
I love everything about this dress. I love the grommets from the shower curtains on the sleeves. I love the ragged edge in the front on the leather. It's amazing.
All right. If you feel the same way our judge does, let's get that vote in. All right. We get it. You gorgeous and thin. We get it. Okay. All right. Next, we have Emily. Come on. Come on, Emily Mitchell. All right, ladies and gentlemen. If you like what she's wearing, we need you to go to slido.com. Judges, did we have a note? Nope.
Can
okay,
you believe
thank
this
you.
Was made out of tarps? It looks like something you would see on the streets of Fort Worth. It's beautifully constructed. The detailing in the back is gorgeous. Great job, Emily.
Yes, great job, Emily. No tarp left behind. All right, next we have Samuel Munson. How we doing, Shay? Okay, Shay. All right. Y'all see all this work? Show them the back. That's what they go up for. Show them the back. Uh-huh. Well, I thought they was going to go up. I went up for it. I just put my lights on a tree. You done made a whole garment. That's incredible. If you like what they're wearing, please go to slido.com. All right. Thank you. I feel connected with you in the turquoise. Thank you for that. Thank you for clapping in my line of sight. All right, next we have Deanna Montalvo. How you doing? You just snapping pictures. Did you get any of me? Okay, thanks. All right, now. All right, if you like what she's wearing, please go to Slido.com. No, I didn't tell you to clap. I told you to go to Slido.com. Y'all, you got to listen. Go to Slido.com and vote. Do we have any notes from our judges?
Yes, can we see the umbrella? That is hand-painted.
There you go.
A Mandela art. Woo! It's absolutely stunning and beautiful. Great job.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. You want to be a little more creative with your umbrella too now, don't you? All right. Thank you, Deanna's the model. All right. You didn't take it off. Okay. Next we have Taylor Moore. Now, Taylor, some of the men probably can't clap because they wives at the table because you look incredible. But I'm telling you now, just clap gently because you look good now. All right, just a little gentle clap, a little ladylike clap, Taylor. Okay. If you like what she's wearing, go to follow.com. It looks like our judges got something they want to share.
Well done, Taylor. You look fabulous, and we love the transformation of your garment.
Thank you. We both did a sliver of skin today, Taylor. Thank you. Don't wear no sliver of skin to work tomorrow, honey. Just get you a little modesty lace or something. Don't do like we did tonight. Okay. Next, we have Tran Fan. Is it Tran Fan or Tran Fan? You know I'm from the South. Tran Fan. Hey, Tran Fan. Yeah, I said Tran Fan Country. It's a truck full of collard greens. All right, if you like what she's wearing, go to philo.com or scan the QR code. Especially to my right, what are you doing? Clap. Thank you. You're so kind. Thank you. Who was that? Tran Fan. Next, we have Fernando Ruiz. Now, I need this little top myself. If you like what she's wearing, please go to philo.com. All right, I see a hand raised. We have a judge with some thoughts.
You know, folks, it's amazing. Look at all the creativity that goes into every one of these fashion folks and what they can find at a Goodwill store to create these incredible outfits.
Yes, I agree. You did great. And just so you know, this shirt came from Goodwill. It's a Chico silk blouse, $6.99. Moving forward, I added the crystals myself. Let's go Ty Washington. This is our last and final contestant. Walking like you're talking. You look incredible. If you like what she's wearing, please go to philo.com and cast your vote. Oh, okay. I see a hand from Well, hold on, sis. We got some words you need to hear. Go ahead.
Ty, it takes a lot to take a lot of different fabrics and a lot of different prints and textures and put them together and make it look as great as you did. This is beautiful. I love the peplum. All the different layers that you put together are amazing.
Great job. Now, judges, y'all done hype these people up and encourage them. If they come looking for you after this over, just remember y'all hype them up. I'm just kidding. All right, have you enjoyed yourselves? Shay and Liz. Liz and Shay. Ooh. They coming, y'all. They in heels just like you. Give them time to get here. Oh, Shay in a pump, baby. Oh, let me find out. I ain't see that little shoe.
Thank you. Y'all, give Anthony a hand. Thank you so much. All right. All right, we are going to get started to wrap up our evening with our wine raffle. Who bought wine raffle tickets? Party at your house. Okay, let's figure out who's going to win. There are three prizes. Third place gets 9 bottles of wine of premium varietals. Second place gets 12 bottles. in first place gets 18 bottles of wine, a one-of-a-kind five-piece art set made by our Great Vine Stars participants. So let's roll the drum. We're rolling for third place first. Maybe. The winner of 9 bottles of premium wine. Number 107. 107, are you still here? I know him. We're going. You can, well. Second place, 12 bottles of wine. 172.
Oh, it's gonna be a good night.
Thank you, sir. And first place, with 18 bottles of wine and our one-of-a-kind five-piece art set is 159. Who is it? All right. Okay, now, audience, that we've gotten the wine out of the way, let's do a little gambling. Let's see who won $500. Please open your mystery boxes now. Who's got the $500? When you win, jump up and scream. I want to see it. We got a winner. You can collect that at checkout. They will have it for you. Just show them that card. Congratulations. Okay, now it's time to find out who won Project Goodwill. David, if you'll join me. If you and Anthony will meet our winners in the center for a photo. Okay. Our social media influencer award. And designer, when we call your name, if you'll join us on the stage, our social media award goes to Marisol Lopez. Please be careful. Here's her model. Thank you. Next, we will announce our People's Choice winner. So you chose the winner. It's up to you. People's Choice is Emily Mitchell.
Y'all get in the middle of the guys.
third place.
Yes.
Of Project Goodwill is Ty Washington. Ty Washington, third place winner. Congratulations. Okay. Second place, Project Goodwill, Emily Mitchell. And our first place winner of Project Goodwill 2024 is Sam Monson. Sam, come on. Congratulations, Sam. And that is our award ceremony. I'll turn it over to David.
Thank you so much, Shay. Can we also have one more round of applause for our host with the most tonight, Anthony L. I would also like to take this opportunity to thank all of our sponsors of tonight's event. I will ask if you would please hold your applause until the end. Our presenting sponsors tonight, once again, are Service Waste and Pan American Wire. Supermodel sponsors are Beth and Craig Collins. Our fashionista sponsors are Triton Networks and WellCare. Paparazzi sponsors, United Healthcare and Virtuoso. Our couture sponsors are Encore, Firefighter Roofing, and JB and Shirley Motes Foundation. Media sponsors are 360 West Magazine, Fort Worth Business Press, The Metro Report, Jim Austin Online, and Clear Channel Outdoor. Our print sponsor this year is Crown Printing. Floral sponsor is Bright Eyed Blooms. Our silent auction sponsor is Luane Hauser. Our swag bag sponsors are Regent Products, Edgar's Bath Goods, and Cancun Cards. Beauty sponsor is the Ogle School. And last but not least, our award sponsor is Trophy Arts. Please join me in giving them a round of applause. As you can all imagine, no event such as tonight's, or no organization for that matter, can be a success without the hard work and the dedication of those who work behind the scenes. Our fearless leader, our board chair of Goodwill North Central Texas, is Pat Gocher. I would like to ask Pat to join me on the stage to close out tonight's program.
I think he said something about fearless there. Only am I fearful of Anthony. But I have something to tell you. When I tell my two adult daughters after tonight that Anthony remembered me from last year, I will have arrived for them. I just want you to know that. Well, what a great evening. We have many, many stars of the show, actually. And I want to just recognize a few others, about 1,000 plus. Now, I won't do that one by one. But I will do it where I will recognize them, I'll ask them to stand, and then if you'll please withhold your applause until I have recognized these 1,000-plus stars of the show. First of all, I want those members of the Project Goodwill Work Group to please stand, wherever you are. Okay? Please don't be bashful. Well, there's two that I think made this all happen. No, that's not true. It's a larger work group than that. These people work year-round to put together an incredible event like we have had this evening and we have every year. And every year we get to see the new fashions. It's an exciting prospect. And we also get to hear Anthony again, help us understand what's going on up here. Now, I want to just keep standing if you're one of those members. If you're an employee of Goodwill, please stand. We have over 1,000 Goodwill employees at Goodwill of North Central Texas. Please keep standing, employees. Then, if you're a board member, I would ask you to stand, please. Our board members have the responsibility to provide oversight, insight, and foresight to a great management team that is, and he's already standing, led by the star of the show for Goodwill, and that is David Cox, an incredible individual, a guy who has a perfect balance of brains and heart. David, thank you, and thank you all. Please thank them all. In the 30 minutes I have left, no, that's not true. In the next couple of minutes, I want to just share a few thoughts with you. I want to challenge all of us to become informed advocates for Goodwill of North Central Texas. Here are a few facts. Although it wasn't until 1915 that the term Goodwill Industries was formed or coined, 1902 became the first year that a Goodwill was established. There was a gentleman, a Reverend Edgar, help me there, Helms, Edgar Helms, who was a member of the Methodist Church back in the early 1900s, and he saw the need that existed with respect to people who had capabilities but would not realize those capabilities because they had no work available, they had no ability to realize their life desires. As a result of that, he began establishing Goodwill organizations. He established many in his lifetime, but since that time, over 150 Goodwill organizations exist around the United States. They represent and manage over 3,000 retail stores in the United States. Therein lies the key with respect to having these retail stores. Virtually all the income that is derived from the goods that are sold at Goodwill stores, it goes back into delivering the true product of what Goodwill is all about, and that is changing lives through work. The opportunity that we give people is a unique opportunity, but it is one that most of us in this room share, and that is the opportunity to work. And through work, we find dignity. I find that Goodwill represents all the right things at this time in our lives. We live in times where values are often hijacked and turned upside down. Goodwill continues to stand tall and hold values that build men and women of character and thereby strong societies focused on the value of work to all its citizens. The only requirement in a situation like this is a person having the desire to work. But in exchange with the opportunity to work, a person experiences human dignity. That is something that without work people oftentimes find difficult to experience. So I will leave you with this tonight with respect to what goodwill does. Goodwill is, I believe, God's will. For we work to help bring about this specific biblical promise to those we serve, which is in the book of Jeremiah. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future. Thank you for your presence this evening. We appreciate you so much. Thank you, Goodwill. Thank you, Anthony. Thank you, everybody that had a part in this. Good night, and God bless you.